Habit is horse automated behaviour identification tool, and it's going to be a piece of software or a range of software tools or libraries that will actually identify horse behaviours automatically from watching video, ideally unconstrained video. That's a video that's actually been shot by the average user on their phone, so it might be the kind of thing you'd see on YouTube. So rather than the kind of video that would have to be recorded in particular circumstances in a laboratory or animals in a stable, we want to be able to do it with any video. So we want to be able to look at a group of horses or an individual horse or a pair of horses and say, what are the behaviours that these horses are actually exhibiting? And very particularly, are these natural behaviours? Because being able to tell whether a behaviour is natural or not tells us things like, is the horse relaxed? Is it stressed? And things like that. Part of this project has been about bringing together an interdisciplinary team, because I'm coming from the computer science side, but I also have a horsemanship background as well, so I understood about horse behaviour, so I had an interest in it. And I've been able to rope in other academics from equitation science and biomechanics and other areas, particularly animal-computer interaction, which is a spin-off from my own human-computer interaction area.
I'm Clara Mancini. I'm a senior lecturer in interaction design at the Open University. I also head the Open University's Animal-Computer Interaction Lab. The lab was set up in 2011, and the whole research field is indeed still emerging. We're coming to a point where technology is so spread in society that animals are getting exposed to it, or they have to interact with it, and we don't yet have technology which is properly user-centered, as we have a lot for humans.
I am Dr. Carol Hall. I work at the School of Animal, Rural and Environmental Sciences here at Nottingham Trent University's Brackenhurst campus, and I'm a reader in equitation science. I got involved with the Habit project because of my experience in studying horse behaviour and welfare, in particular the welfare and behaviour of ridden horses. This project has potential to reduce the time and increase the objectivity of scoring behaviour. Currently, if you want to actually record horse behaviour, either in a research setting or in a performance analysis setting, it's all based on human judgment. Even the software tools that are actually currently available rely on a human watching video clips and recording the behaviour that they observe. There are problems then with consistency and experimental bias and all sorts of things, but the main problem is the time that it takes. So for an hour of video footage, you could be spending several weeks analysing the behaviour that you see. There's also, in the ridden horse world particularly, judging ridden horse behaviour is the basis of dressage performance judging, for example, and that again can be very subjective. And the way it's done at the moment, not all the more subtle signs of performance, welfare, affective state, all these things that we should be actually judging in dressage can be seen by the judge very clearly.
I'm Mandy Rosier. I'm an assistant professor at Nottingham Vet School, and here I teach mainly anatomy and animal behaviour. And my reason for becoming involved in the Habit project it was to bring the sort of elements of this discipline to the team. So the anatomical knowledge, the understanding of behaviour, and really looking at how the anatomy contributes to the things that the behaviour tool will be measuring. From my perspective, I spend a lot of time talking to the students about animal interactions, and it's really important that you're able to sort of look at an animal and try and work out what maybe its body language means, try and interpret its emotional state. And using equipment that helps us measure and understand behaviour helps give us insights, and so hopefully we can try and understand communication a little bit more. So this tool will help with that element, so that measuring of behaviour.
What computers can do, can they do better than us, at least so far, they can gather enormous amounts of data and they can sift through and process very quickly and take into account many parameters that might escape our attention perhaps. And also technology can be there all the time. They can, you know, a monitoring device could be placed in the environment where the animals are, and 24/7, which is a bit impractical to do for a human. So is, at this stage at least, it's not the technology that makes judgments, but the technology can provide a lot of data and do some processing of that data to aid its interpretation.
I wanted to be really careful that we brought the animal science people in from the beginning and said what would be really helpful to you. We were funded for an initial phase on this, and that was partly about forming our group, meeting up and starting to investigate things. What we really need is a thorough technology phase to investigate the best way forward.
We often say, if only animals could talk, is this what we're trying to achieve?
We're certainly trying to give animals a voice. It's a way to allow them to comment on things.